Hello and welcome to our service from St. James in Fuerteventura. Wherever you're watching across the world, we welcome you. All the words for the service today are on the screen. My words are in orange and your words are in blue. And you may wish to have some bread and wine or an alternative to share alongside us later in the service. Our theme for today is hard love. Let's just take a few moments now and listen to the music and prepare ourselves to meet with God.
Light of the world, you step down into darkness, open my eyes, let me see beauty that made his heart adore you, hope of a life spent with you. Here I
The Lord is here. His spirit is with us. Loving Lord, open our hearts to your presence. Open our ears to your voice. Open our eyes to see your kingdom here in this place. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you
and also with you.
And now we're going to sing this marvellous hymn all about what God has done for us in Jesus.
Thank you.
And as we've sung about God's marvellous love for us, it may have made us consider times when we have failed to recognise that love in our lives. Let's take a few moments to consider this past week before we make our confession. Father eternal, giver of light and grace, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in what we have thought, in what we have said and done, through ignorance, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We have wounded your love and marred your image in us. We are sorry and ashamed, and repent of all our sins, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and lead us from darkness to walk as children of light. Amen. Jesus gave his life for us on the cross, so that we can be forgiven. To all who are truly sorry and believe and trust in him, Jesus says, "Your sins are forgiven. Go and sin no more." Amen. Amen. Thanks be to God. And now, let's join together as we declare what God has done for us in the words of the Creed from Philippians chapter 2, verses 6 to 11. Let us declare our faith in Christ. He was in very nature God, but did not consider equality with God something to be used to his own advantage. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a human being, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Our reading is taken from 1 Corinthians 13, verses 1 to 13, and is read for us by David Reed from El Cotillo.
If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends, but as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide. These three, and the greatest of these, is love.
This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And now Bob is going to speak to us on our theme, hard love.
Picture this. You rock up at the gates of heaven and you see Peter there by the entrance with his virtual supercomputer, unlimited memory, instantaneous response, all linked to the eternal cloud. Now, obviously, this is just a formality. No question, you'll just float right through the gates. So you start to rattle off your spiritual credentials. You have spoken to so many people about Jesus. You've added a few different languages so that you could get the message across to other folk as well. And when you ran out of words, you just spoke in tongues. And then there were those prophecies. You remember the ones? You uttered them proclaiming God's judgment on failing church leaders wherever you found them. And then a PhD in New Testament theology means that you know the scriptures inside out. Hebrew and Greek are just second nature to you. You have enough faith to shift the Alps halfway around the world. You've given all your money to charity, and the reason you're here now is because you stepped in and took the blame when some religious fanatics were looking for a Christian who'd torn up one of their holy texts. Way to go, you martyr, you. Now, yeah, they've not had somebody here with half your credentials. You're head and shoulders above the rest. They'll be honoured just to have you. And surely there'll be some extra special accommodation set aside for you. A heavenly palace, all to yourself. But Peter looks concerned. "What do you mean there's something missing?" you shout out. "I have spent years pulling all this lot together. I've ticked all the boxes. I've brought enough copies of all my documents. I've even brought the extra Spanish ones too." It's all there in black and white. But Peter seems unmoved. You bang your fist on the desk. You've had enough. This is just taking too long. "Just open the gates," you demand, more than a little irritated by the delay. "I have a right to be in here. Just bring your manager. I want to speak to your manager. Get Jesus out here, you little Jobsworth." "Well, there aren't any managers here," says Peter. "Just servants. But Jesus will be here in a moment." "And there's Jesus. He's standing right before you. And as he looks at you with love, his eyes are just filled with tears and the sadness. "My precious, precious child," he says, "you are so close and yet so far from the kingdom of heaven. Yes, it all looks good on paper, but there's one thing missing. Love. You see, it was all about you. Everything that you've said and done was about you. Yes, you talked about me. You learned about me. You did everything religiously. But it was all about you. You wanted to look good in front of others. You wanted people to admire you and look up to you. You wanted it all, but you wanted it for yourself. It wasn't about faith. It was about knowledge. It wasn't about hope. It was about your rights. And it certainly wasn't about love. Yes, you had love, but only for yourself. Everything that you did and said was for your own glory and not mine. Interesting scenario, that. When we look at Jesus, there's quite a contrast with that figure in our story. Everything that Jesus said and did was for others, and out of his love relationship with his Heavenly Father. He responded to the needs of those around him because he loved them. His heart broke when he shared in the grief of those around him. He looked with compassion on a world that was lost. His anger with the religious authorities was out of love, out of a concern that they too should see beyond the narrow confines of rules and regulations, to see the love of God for them and for others. Jesus wanted them to see that it was about more than just appearances. It was about a desire to seek God's kingdom and his concerns, not just ours. And he wasn't looking at us meeting some standards set in stone. Nothing that Jesus did was for his own glory. And on those occasions when his glory was revealed, like the Transfiguration, he told his disciples not to tell anybody else about it until after his resurrection. When you look at the commandments, Jesus summarized them as being about love. Love for God and love for our neighbour. Yes, we're meant to love others as we love ourselves. And we've looked at that on many occasions. But it should never be about loving ourselves over and above others for the sake of ourselves. And it's not about what we can get out of it. It's about what we can give to it. And love is practical. It's seen in service. And if we go through and substitute the word serve in place of the word love, it can help us to see some of the realities of what love looks like. Serve God. Serve your neighbour. It's all in there. Our reading from Corinthians lists the different qualities of love. And when we embody love in our lives, then those words should describe us. So if you read them again, it's we are patient. We are kind. We are not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. We do not insist on our own way. We're not irritable or resentful. We do not rejoice in wrongdoing, but we rejoice in the truth. We bear all things, we believe all things, hope all things, endure all things. We never end. Just have a look again at 1 Corinthians 13 and put yourself in place of the word love. See how that works out. We never end. And that's the outcome. In terms of eternal life, we never end. Our bodies are simply transformed from earthly bodies into spiritual bodies in the fullness of God's kingdom. Now, don't get me wrong. None of this is easy. Love is hard. It's hard work. It's sacrificial. And it's particularly hard when it comes to loving our enemies, those whom we radically disagree with and those who deliberately harm others. and love flies out of the window when we desire revenge and retribution rather than justice. And love's never seen when we lash out at those who've hurt us or hurt those whom we love. When harsh words are spoken in the heat of the moment are not followed up with repentance and a desire for forgiveness, we fail to respond in love. It's never easy, and so often we fail. Our pride might take a hammering when we admit we're wrong and seek forgiveness, but that's all part of the process of love. Just think for a moment about those whom you vehemently disagree with in the world of politics, those whose words and actions are totally at odds with your own. And then think how you can love them. Think about somebody who's guilty of abusing a child. What are your thoughts about them? Is there a seeking for justice or some seeking of retribution and punishment just so they can learn a lesson? Love can be seen in standing up for what's right. Speak out for the vulnerable, even when you know that it might make you the victim of verbal and even physical abuse yourself. Confronting a friend or a family member about their attitude to others, that's a hard one. Or telling someone about the love of God for them through Jesus. If you love them, then you will want what's best for them in terms of their own standing before God. Yes, love might mean overturning a few tables or speaking hard truths to those in authority. And if we enjoy it, then we shouldn't be doing it because it's not about love. If it hurts us to do that, then it is about love because it comes out of our concern. Yeah, we're not going to get it right all the time. We are going to mess up, often on that spur of the moment where our anger and our hurt is greater than our love. But if our love can grow back to overcome our anger, then we're back on track. You see, it won't be easy to follow the path of love. That same path led Jesus to the cross. Our love for him and for others should simply mean picking up our own cross and following Jesus' lead wherever it might take us. Amen.
Let's respond to what we have heard using this following song, Change My Heart, O God.
Change my heart, O God, make it ever true. Change my heart, O God, may I be like you. Change my heart, O God. Heart, O God, may I be like you. You are the potter, I am the clay. Mold me and make me, this is what I pray. Change. change my heart, oh God.
Come change my heart.
Make it ever true.
Make it ever true.
Change my heart, oh God.
Prayers today are led for us by Jan Hopkins.
As tonight we have listened to one of the most beautiful passages in the Bible and have learned that, as the song says, all we need is love, let us pray on this theme. And as we do, when I say, Your kingdom come, please reply, Your will be done. This reading is often used at weddings. We pray for those getting married in the coming months, that the love they experience for each other now will last and grow throughout the years to come. Your kingdom come.
Your will be done.
We pray for couples for whom the spark of love has all but disappeared as they face the day-to-day trials of family life, children, financial constraints, ill health, especially mental ill health, and extra pressures caused by the pandemic over an extended period. We pray that they will be brave enough to seek outside help to see them through their difficulties. Give counsellors wisdom and love in their hearts so they may listen non-judgmentally to guide their clients through difficult periods. May the love of these clients for their family ensure that the lives of their children will not be unduly impacted by the couple's problems. Your kingdom come.
Your will be done.
We pray for children who receive very little love from their parents, especially those who are victims of parental abuse, both physical and mental. We pray too for the abuse perpetrators, who we find so difficult to understand and even more difficult to love. May we be mindful of the fact that they too were often victims of similar abuse and have never been shown love themselves. We pray that with intervention from appropriate sources, the cycle of deprivation may be broken so that they may learn to love themselves and those in their care. Your kingdom come.
Your will be done.
We pray for politicians that they may govern with respect and love for the people they represent, that they may, in the words of our reading, put an end to childish ways that have been sometimes evident in recent times. We pray for rulers in places of conflict who allow unimaginable horrors, such as the news of an Afghani mother who has sold two daughters and her own kidney and is still destitute. Soften the hearts of these rulers that they may show respect and love for their fellow people and rule with justice and fairness. Your kingdom come.
Your will be done.
We pray for prisoners who are so often deemed to be unlovable. May they show contrition for any crimes they have committed and learn how to love others through the care and attention they receive from prison staff, chaplains, and prison visitors. Your kingdom come.
Your will be done.
Finally, we pray that we show love to others throughout our daily lives, not only to those we have chosen as partners and friends, but the people we find difficult to interact with, remembering that we are all God's own children. May we meet indifference with care, unpleasantness with kindness, anger with tolerance, and hostility with love, as we remember Jesus urged us to love our neighbour as ourselves.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. And now let's bring all our prayers together in the words that Jesus taught us, the Lord's Prayer. Pray either in the version on the screen, in the version you know best, or in your own language. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. As part of the offering of yourself to God, you may wish to send a donation for the work of the chaplaincy across Fuerteventura. Some of what we receive is given to support the Spanish Association Against Cancer and its work on this island, and some to Tear Fund for international relief and development work. Details for donations are on the website. And now we're going to sing again. Act justly, love mercy, walk humbly.
With
So we give thanks to God in our Eucharistic prayer. The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is right to praise you, Father, Lord of all creation. In your love, you made us for yourself. And when we turned away, you did not reject us, but came to meet us in your Son. You embraced us as your children and welcomed us to sit and eat with you. In Christ, you shared our life, that we might live in him and he in us. He opened his arms of love upon the cross and made for all the perfect sacrifice for sin. On the night he was betrayed, at supper with his friends, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His body is the bread of life. At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me."
Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His blood is shed for all.
As we proclaim his death and celebrate his rising in glory, send your Holy Spirit, that this bread and this wine may be to us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy gifts, make us one in Christ, our risen Lord. With your whole church throughout the world, we offer you this sacrifice of praise and lift our voice to join the eternal song of heaven.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in the one bread. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup,
we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
All are welcome at Christ's table. Eat this and remember Jesus.
Amen.
Drink this and remember Jesus.
Amen.
Never be forgotten throughout.
Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to love and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Our notices are on the website at 30church.org. And we are continuing with continuing gifts of love. So any bags of food or toiletries that you have for the mission, please drop them off either at Casa Bob or church, or you can request a pickup. And to raise further monies for the mission, we have been donated a weekend in an apartment in the Beverly Hills Villa in Costa Calma. And there's going to be a prize draw. So donations of €10 are required if you want to take part. So contact Bob. Our midweek in-person fellowship groups won't be meeting whilst we remain in level 3 restrictions. So please consult the website calendar and social media regularly for updates on all our services and meetings. Our regular Sunday service at 10 o'clock in Cotillo is suspended this week until the 6th of February as the restaurant staff are on holiday. But we still have our 6 o'clock service in Corralejo and are continuing all our online services. And now, let's join these wonderful singers in Llandaff Cathedral in Cardiff to sing Love Divine, or Love's Excelling.
Thank you.
Father, who so loved the world that he gave his only Son, bring you by faith to his eternal life. May Christ, who accepted the cup of sacrifice in obedience to the Father's will, keep you steadfast as you walk with him the way of his cross. And may the Spirit, who strengthens us to suffer with Christ, that we may share his glory, set your minds on life and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be upon you now and forever.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ.
Amen.